Welcome to this short screencast from LSE Life on how to use a Gantt chart for your dissertation research. A dissertation is a project and as such requires planning. It is important to think about what you need to do in terms of the content, when you need to do it in terms of what your timeline is, and how you will do it in terms of what materials you will need. If you haven't done so yet, please download the Gantt chart worksheet from the Moodle page where you found this screencast. Okay, so let's think a little bit about time plans. All time plans should set milestones to ensure your dissertation is ready for handing in on time. All time plans should include a schedule of work which specifies drafting, rewriting, printing, and binding if necessary. It's a good idea to factor in additional time for the unexpected things or things taking longer than you thought they would. All time plans should factor in when you can get the data you need. For example, make sure the books you need are available online. So let's start with your blank Gantt chart. Let's start filling this in with the important stages of your dissertation. We've put 10 basic ones here as an example. This is a good starting point, but the more specific you can be with your own project stages, the better. Next, you need to set a time to begin and to end each of these project stages. You can add them into the plan here. Then you can mark these across the relevant weeks on the Gantt chart. Finally, you can use this column to keep track of how you are progressing. Very often our plans differ from what actually happens. Don't worry, this is perfectly normal. Here is a real-life example to help you see more clearly how this can work effectively. So that's it. Good luck with your planning. And don't forget, LSE Life is here to help you throughout the dissertation process.